I never even dreamed that it was possible. I found that enormous appetite. I used to see it also in Malaysia and in Indonesia, but not as sharp as in France.
Ini bangsa ni bangsa hebat. Bangsa ni berdarah hebat. Darah pejuang yang pernah perang, yang pernah berlawan dengan Fir'aun. Ini bangsa orang lain. Belanda berjaya mengkristianikan orang umat Islam di Indonesia. Tapi Portugis tak berjaya mengkristianikan seorang pun orang lain.
Sebelumnya terima kasih buat para dermawan yang sudah join member dan juga berdonasi di channel ini. Semoga sehat selalu, panjang umur, berkah rezeki dan bahagia keluarganya. Amin amin ya rabbal alamin. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Jumpa lagi dengan saya guys, Cak Mujib. Gimana kabar teman-teman semua? Semoga sehat selalu dalam lindungan Allah Subhanahu wa taala, dijauhkan dari segala mara bahaya, malapetaka bencana dan balak serta berbagai macam penyakit. Amin amin ya rabbal alamin. Alright guys, sebelum menonton video ini lebih lanjut, marilah kita doakan saudara-saudara kita yang ada di Palestina. Semoga diberikan kekuatan oleh Allah Subhanahu wa taala, diberikan kesabaran dan ketabahan, dan semoga Allah Subhanahu wa taala memberikan kemenangan ya kepada saudara-saudara kita di Palestina. Allahu Akbar. Dan senantiasalah kita doakan selepas sholat, Allahumma ansur ikhwanana fi Falastin wa fi kulli makan ya. Jadi kita doakan bersama ya guys ya. Kita tidak bisa ke sana tapi dengan doa kita, karena doa itu tidak ada yang sia-sia, pasti diijabah oleh Allah Subhanahu wa taala. Maka daripada itu, senjata orang mukmin, senjata orang yang beriman kepada Allah adalah doanya. Allahu Akbar. Tanpa berlama-lama, langsung saja guys, kita akan mereaksi sebuah video. Di sini ada syekh yang sudah terkenal oleh banyak orang ya. Seluruh muslim dunia mungkin sudah kenal dengan Syekh Imran Nazar Husin, dan beliau ya di sini membahas tentang bab bangsa Melayu di akhir zaman. Saya penasaran sekali guys ya, bagaimana istilahnya disampaikan oleh Syekh Imran Husin ini. Tanpa berlama-lama, langsung saja guys, kita upload videonya. Let's go.
Question, Muslims and non-Muslim alike, they live in a state of confusion. It's come to a point where people don't believe anything anymore, and I refer here to what they hear in the news. We know that, or they know that most of what they hear is most probably going to be lies, fabrications. We now hear of fake news, even though the concept is as old as the printing press, if not even older. What guidance can Islam offer to such Muslim and non-Muslims alike in these times of confusion?
My experience has been, and at the age of 76, I do have some experience, and I have traveled. I've been blessed to travel extensively. He said, yes, you are correct. There is a large part of the world of Islam out there which is asleep. And part of it is misguided. But the good news, which warms my heart, is that as I travel in the world, and now that we have the internet, we're able to go over all the walls and roadblocks that they established to prevent our world from reaching the people. I am amazed of how our young people in particular, our young people are able to grasp the truth and recognize the reality of the world today. And in some instances, they listen to me and then they advance my talk. And then I look and say, MashaAllah, look at that. Look at this thinker, this young man who is thinking. And nowhere, I have found it, yes, amongst in France, the Arabs in France who have migrated from Algeria and Morocco and Tunisia and so on, and they've been flocking to me. I have found from amongst them this cutting-edge capacity for thinking.
Okay.
And to my surprise, I found native Frenchmen, French people, who have become my students, and who are also capable of this same capacity to think in depth and recognize the truth. I used to see it also in Malaysia and in Indonesia, but not as sharp as in France. And now that, I don't know about the United States, because I left the United States 2 weeks after 9/11, and I never set foot again over there. Yeah, but over the last 1 year, I've been visiting Britain. I came here 1 year ago to see my grandson, because I was 75 years of age and my grandson was going to be 4 I had never seen, and I was afraid I might die without ever seeing my grandson. I didn't know what the British government would do if I were to set foot in Britain. Mm-hmm. I'd never come to Britain for about 15 years or more. Mm-hmm. So I took a chance. I took a chance to come, mm-hmm. so I could see my grandson. Mm-hmm. And many people, of course, criticized me for that. Never mind. I wanted to see my grandson. But when I came to Britain 1 year ago, it was something absolutely amazing. I never even dreamed that it was possible. I found an enormous appetite amongst the young people in Britain, the young Muslims in Britain, born here. An enormous appetite to understand the reality of the world today. And they were flocking to me from all corners. And more than that, I found the scholars of Islam who were the graduates of the Darul Uloom in this country. And while the schoolboys who managed the masjid, the management committee, while they were closing the doors of the masjid for me, there were so many imams, so many maulanas, so many scholars, yeah. who were flocking to me who want the knowledge of what is the reality of the world today. They were impressed by the methodology that they taught to me, how to use the Quran, how to study the Quran, to be able to understand the world, its political reality, its economic reality, its monetary reality. And this is a good sign, that while one part of there is asleep, and another part is misguided, there is another part which is fresh, young, vigorous, and exciting in their thirst for this knowledge. That's a good sign.
Orang Melayu ni, Allah Masalah Ala Sayyidina, mewarisi pembuatan besi. Besi ni bukankah teknologi Nabi Allah Daud, ayah Nabi Allah Sulaiman alaihi salam. Ni bangsa ni bangsa hebat. Bangsa ni berdarah hebat. Darah pejuang yang pernah perang, yang pernah berlawan dengan Fir'aun. Ni bangsa orang Melayu. Sebab tu Yahudi, Dino, Yahudi di Palestin tu, soalan Sayyidina Muhammad, dia ada pantang larang dengan bangsa ni. Dia ada pantang larang lah. Dia terlibat lebih kurang. Dia tak boleh hapuskan. Dia tak boleh hapuskan kesultanan tanah Melayu tu. Kalau dia hapuskan, dia masalah. Cumanya dia kena bersilat. Macam mana dia nak berpolitik dengan bangsa ni. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad. Dia macam ni. Ulang macam ulang. Ulang. Ulak ni yang dia tak biang dia ulak ni pantang dia buluh. Bila buluh, kena buluh langsung jadi lemah. Itulah bangsa Bani Israel dengan orang Melayu. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad. Ada sekali cerita ni cerita Allahumma salli ala saya dengar daripada sebagian kawan-kawan yang dengar cerita operasi apa tu? Operasi keamanan tu nak pergi ke Gaza daripada Turki, apa nama namanya? Bara Marmara ke? Kapal tu, kapal yang bawa operasi tu. Yang diketuai oleh Turki dan termasuk apa ni? Allahumma salli ala sayyidina. Termasuk yang menyertai itu ialah apa ni? NGO kemanusiaan daripada Malaysia. Yang diceritakan pada saya masalah Sayyidina Muhammad, bila kapal Bara Marmara tu nak bawa, bukan kapal perang, nak bawa makanan nak hantar pergi Gaza, bila sampai di tengah laut, Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad, dekat dengan sepala Israel, helikopter Israel datang. Turun, lepas turun atas kapal ini, masalah Allah Syamad, ada ramai yang mati. Jadi, hak kapal ini bertempur. Bertempur tanpa senjata, mempertahankan diri. Yang turun itulah komando Israel. Yang menariknya, bila sampai kepada orang Melayu, masalah Allah Syamad Muhammad, dia tak dah, apa ni, machine gun dia tu, dan telah menyala dah laser tu, nak tembak boleh dah. Soalannya, are you Malaysian? How are Malaysia? Bila kata ya, dia tarik balik. Dia tak boleh.
Wow.
Ada satu orang tu, subhanallah, masalah Sayyidina Muhammad, dia lawan dengan komando tu pakai hos bomba. Padahal kan dia ada machine gun. Dia boleh tembak, tapi dia tak boleh. Mereka kena buat cara lain orang Melayu ni. Malaysia ni. Suatu mana penjajah main ke tanah Melayu, masalah Sayyidina Muhammad. Penjajah menjajah seluruh dunia, seluruh alam. Belanda masuk, masuk Indonesia. Portugis masuk, masuk ke tanah Melayu, masalah Sayyidina Muhammad. Belanda berjaya mengkristiankan orang umat Islam Indonesia. Tapi Portugis tak berjaya mengkristiankan seorang pun
bangsa
orang Melayu.
Wah, orang Melayu.
Ini bangsa kita. Tak mampu. Sampai di Indonesia berjaya sampai hari ini dalam satu keluarga ada Kristian, ada Islam. Malaysia tak boleh. Kalau ada orang Melayu pun murtad di Kuala Lumpur, balik kampung, dia tak tunjuk Kristian dia. Ha, tu walaupun dah ada persatuan Melayu Kristian, tapi tak boleh nyata. Pasal dia ada, orang kata apa, ada daulat. Tak boleh. Akhirnya subhanallah, bila Portugis tak mampu, berdaya Belanda masuk ke tanah Melayu. Kami berjaya buat di Indonesia. Bila mai pun sama, tak boleh. Tak boleh buat. Akhirnya yang berjaya menguasai orang Melayu ialah British, orang putih. Bila orang putih mai, dia tak buat macam mereka buat di sana. Dia cara lembut. Bangsa yang tak boleh tukar cara kasar. Dia kena dari segi akidah, dia dapat istiqomah. Allahumma salli ala sayyidina Muhammad. Lepas tu Allahumma salli ala sayyidina Muhammad, maka macam cara buat, cara lembut, cara membut, masalah ala sayyidina Muhammad. Ha, seperti berlaku lah. Akhirnya mereka tak boleh ubah, tapi cara hidup mereka boleh ubah. Orang Melayu, Islam Melayu ni, akidah tak boleh ubah, tapi cara hidup boleh ubah. Orang putih balik, sampai hari ni kita masih mewarisi cara hidup orang putih. Allahumma salli ala sayyidina Muhammad. Maknanya, tapi kita dah sedaah. Alhamdulillah, masalah Sayyidina Muhammad. Jadi subhanallah, maka sebenarnya yang duk jaga kerajaan Malaysia ni ialah kerajaan batin. Yang duk jaga tu, kerajaan wali-wali.
Allahumma salli ala sayyidina Muhammad. Alright guys, itulah tadi ya yang dikatakan oleh Syekh Imran Hussein dan juga Syekh Zainul Asri berkenaan dengan bangsa Melayu. Masya Allah, Allahu Akbar. Dan ya, kita dapat menambah wawasan dan pengetahuan tentunya daripada nasihat-nasihat ataupun yang disampaikan oleh kedua syekh ini. Oke, itu saja video kali ini guys. Semoga bermanfaat dan semoga kita semakin cinta lagi ya dengan negara kita ini, Indonesia dan juga Malaysia. Dan karena kita, kalau kita bersatu ini guys, sudah tumbang semua kayaknya udah. Oke, itu saja video kali ini. Terima kasih, sampai jumpa di video selanjutnya. Apabila ada salah kata mohon dimaafkan. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. I've been driving this train, years in this lane, there's no stopping this flame, 'cause I came to the game and I changed it to play how I like, rearrange.